I did not know Rowley Inn was by the Christmas Story house. I ain't never been to the Christmas Story house.
You ain't?
Have you?
Me and Sheila went. That was what one of her things she wanted to go to.
I never been. I want to go to the Christmas. We're at the last Yelp event of the year at Barella's coffee shop. It's a pop-up of Sweet Costco. Okay, so this is Barella's. It's very eclectic looking in here. I wonder what it looks like when it's not Christmas time, but a lot happening. It looks like Sally Jesse Raphael. In the mall, not Bath and Body Works, but a mine to get in again. It's crazy. Let's stay focused. We're not trying to be in the mall all day. Focus. We need a gift. We need to pick up. We need to drop off. We need to get home. This whole no Nike stuff is weird to me. Like, am I supposed to wear Fila's, Puma's, Reebok? I can't. I literally cannot. That's just not gonna happen. Okay, so I'm in JCPenney right now, and I went over in the men's department looking for Golden Girls t-shirts, because they usually have them around this time of year, and if I'm able to, I'll get me and my girls matching shirts, because we love the Golden Girls. So I asked the guy over in the department if they had any, because I don't mean to be, but I am that person who will tear up your display, okay, looking for what I want, and it's not purposeful. And it took a friend of mine to point it out, and I'm like, dang, I come in like a wrecking ball. So I asked him out of courtesy, and he was like, well, you don't look like the typical Golden Girls fan. And I said, why not? And he was like, well, that's like something my grandma would like. That's what I mean. And I'm like, everybody likes the Golden Girls. Me and my friends love the Golden Girls. I mean, I was like, you know all those shows with four women living together, or just that dynamic, Sex in the City? That's based on the Golden Girls. What are you talking about? Like, I love the Golden Girls, and you can't judge a Golden Girls fan by its cover. Like, you think only people that watch Golden Girls old women? Please. Men like the Golden Girls. Manly men like the Golden Girls. They ain't gonna tell you, but they do. So, that was a little off-putting. But anyway, long story short, they ain't had no shirts. Do y'all got friends with big boobies that be trying to play you? Like, my friends tried to play me at dinner the other day. He was talking about bra sizes, and one of them was talking about how I posted a video and had her bra size out there. And I'm like, okay. Then we got on the subject, and I was like, oh, they said something about my bra size. And they was like, what, it's a something something B or something like that. They tried to play me. First of all, I'm C-cup, been one, okay? And then they was trying to play me like it was at Victoria's Secret, because everybody know Victoria's Secret bras run small. And I'm like, no, that's the real size at Victoria's Secret. I'm a D girl, voluptuous. Get it right. There's always some big titty women coming for you. Forget y'all. I'm voluptuous. Bath and Body Works is back at it with this line to buy candles. It's the candle day. I got my. I'm at JCPenney, Chinese coupon, trying to just find myself something to buy myself. What you think? I think it's really basic. I feel like I can make this. But it's black, it fits. I'm covered, I'll be relatively warm. This is a medium and it is huge. It's not, it's fitting like it's a extra large. I don't know if it's, the dress is supposed to be loose. Like loose. But, it's very big. Very big. Thought it was gonna be fitted. They're too short. Look at the pants, like. They was long enough. It's real. See the pants they make? They all crotchy. My waist was way down here, but it's not. My waist is up here. And they feel comfy and everything. They're just too short. So it's a no. What's with these ankle pants? Do I really want some with buttons? Okay, another pair of bad fitting. Just bad fitting jeans. Ugh. I think I need a 10. This is a cute shirt.
The question is, what am I gonna wear it with?
I see already.
What am I wear it with?
What they doing? I think it's two or three people in a fit room.
Yep.
This is it in cream. I think this shirt's cute.
This parking lot at the mall is so dark. You can't even see how to get out. I almost ran into a divider. And I got my bright, I had to turn my brights on. That's how dark it is over here. Desolate. This lady at the register was all sniveling and stuff. Ain't got no mask on. I'm like, girl, Joe sniveling ass out of here. Ugh. I hope she ain't sick. Sniveling. Anyway, okay, this part is light. I can turn my brights off.
Okay, so I'm down in Hingetown. Oh my God, look at that dog. Okay. Down in Hingetown, heading to Cleveland Tea Revival, one of my favorite little spots to get tea. Ugh. Buy your friend a tea. It appears my friend bought me a tea. So, the menu.
Of course.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Okay.
Tea for one, okay. Extra fine tea,
yeah,
infuser.
It's just the romaine that usually is with it, as the base. And then if you want, we can add avocado or
a gift boxes.
Look at, there used to be nothing, nothing here. Now there's, ooh, camo. And then these things, I have no idea what these are. This dude. What is that? So, they're flexible live workspaces, move-in ready or built to suit. Cleveland draw architecture, Erie Bank. Interesting.
Okay, so I just went to one of my favorite tea shops in town. It's in Hingetown. It's called the Cleveland Tea Revival. Love that place since I discovered it years ago. Now it's COVID, so they have a limit of 3 people inside at once. So I'm inside. We're at our cap of 3 customers. Then one of the guys leave and 2 ladies come in. So that kind of made me mad. Can y'all not read? We're at capacity. You just made us over capacity by both of you coming in. Okay. Then the guy who's in there, the other guy, has a dog with him. Okay, you got your dog. A lot of places are dog friendly. All right, fine. I'm reading the board to see if my friend bought me a tea, because they have a buy a friend a tea board. And of course she did. Shout out to Naturally Aaliyah. And then I feel something on my leg. And I turn around, and it's his dog. And I don't care if you bring your dog everywhere you go. That's your business. But you can't assume everyone likes dogs or wants your dog on them. That is where you get inconsiderate. So all I'm saying is, if you're going to bring your dog places, control your dog. Keep them off of people. Everybody don't want your dog on them. And that's just it. I see you. You got dog hair on your socks, all over your clothes and stuff. Well, guess what I don't want? Dog hair on me. And I got on black leggings. I don't want dog hair on me. I don't have a dog. If I had a dog, I wouldn't have dog hair all over me. But if that's what you want, that's your prerogative. But don't make that my burden as well. That's all I'm saying. I put my phone on Do Not Disturb, and I keep getting disturbed. If my phone, if somebody calls or anything, it won't ring, but it sure as heck stops my music. And it's starting to annoy me. I should put it on airplane mode or something. Yeah, I guess that's what you gotta do. Okay, so I am in Lucky's Market. Specifically looking for lavender. I've gotten in here before. However, this isn't enough. This is only 0.4 ounces. And then this is 1.5 ounces. It's $10.99. Didn't really want to spend that much. Ooh, Luffy's is known for having a DJ. And I think that's a DJ. Yep, I gotta. They have a DJ. I love Lucky.
for that very reason. Like, who goes to the grocery store and then is a DJ?
Hey. Hi. Aziza's stuff is in here. Nice. Yeah. Nice. $19. Shea butter, hemp seed oil. Hot oil treatments. That's what's up. Huh. And she got her. Okay, girl. I see you, Aziza. Ooh. F-bombs. Are those cakes? Is that a name for cake pops? How much are these? These are $15. What else they got? Cheesecake. Wine under $10. And it smells like a food co-op in here. Which I spent a lot of my childhood at the food co-op. So the smell is familiar and I enjoy it. And then they have their hot kitchen area. And you can get their five signature sandwiches for $5. Oh, and a soup and a sandwich. Ooh, chicken noodle. All right. And then they have a bar. So you can get a glass of wine. You can sip and stroll while you shop. That isn't an option. Oh, wait. They got rotisseries that come in different flavors depending on the day of the week. And on Wednesdays, the original flavor is $5. And the other day is $6.99. I didn't know that. I'm assuming this is Cajun. I don't know. I don't know if they know what Cajun means. Might be too hot. Hot enough. African market basket. This one helps provide healthcare and school supplies and support the weavers and their families and their villages. Okay. But yeah, you can sip and stroll. I have to go
to the Asian grocery store. How much is this bok choy? $1.49 a pound. The DJ going in. For your thoughts. That's funny. Strawberry juice, Fuji apple juice, cranberry, blackcurrant, raspberry, red jacket. I kind of want to try it. Probably not for $5.49, not today, but still. All the milk, black milk, oat milk, almond milk, regular milk. All right, let me get out of here. Oh, the tea. I also have the Crofton gold and rose gold measuring cups for $6.99. And a plethora of other items, cooking and Christmas inspired. All right, so we're making ramen. So we got some leeks, bamboo shoots, mint, that's not for that, baby bok choy, ginger. Okay. What else do I need? Mitchum's fish market in Whittier. See. To a pop up. So let's see.
26, too much swag now. 28, wearing tight shirts and skinnies, walked around with the ass out. Y'all better cash out. Go put your cash up, cause I'm all in.
I'm
a mess. I had to get a Leah sock. Huh? I think I'm gonna
sell them on everybody. I got hat. He's got
lucky hat. Socks are them one bad hat, never bad.
And there's the one.
What's the
shit?
What's the
lots of windows, great light.